Hi friends, in this video we are going to see the most important parameter, or you can say a most important application of AC voltage. That is, if I pass AC supply through series connection of inductor and resistance, then what will be the nature of current, power, power factor, etc. So let's see a circuit diagram. So here I am having a series connection of resistance and a inductor where sinusoidal AC voltage is applied. So voltage applied, I take as a reference, so I will get a V of t equal to Vm sin omega t. Now because of this voltage, current I will be drawn from the supply, which will pass through resistance and a inductor. Same current will pass because these two elements are in series. Because of this current I, there will be two voltage drops developed across two passive elements. First, drop across pure resistance denoted as Vr and given by I into R, simple Ohm's law. Same current I is responsible for a voltage drop across pure inductor, and that is VL equal to I into XL. Remember, XL is 2πfL, which is also called as inductive reactance. Now we have seen earlier slide that whenever current and voltage is denoted in a phasor diagram, as far as pure resistance is concerned, both are in phase. That means both are in one line, either on a one line or parallel to each other, but the phase angle between them will be zero. Same is the case whenever we study pure inductance under the influence of AC voltage. Now if I consider current passing through it like this, voltage leads current by 90 degree in the case of pure inductor. So I will get a phasor diagram like this. Now what I want, if I add these two voltages, what will be the supply voltage? So by Kirchhoff's voltage law, applied voltage V bar equal to Vr bar plus VL bar. See, voltage and current here are vectors, because along with the magnitude it will have a phase angle. So Vr we denoted as I into R, and VL we denoted as I into XL. Now being a series circuit, I will consider current as a reference. So reference means it is along the positive x axis direction. Vr is nothing but a voltage across a resistance which will be in phase with the current I. So this is Vr bar. VL bar, since we know for a pure inductance, voltage leads current by 90 degree. So this is VL, and vector addition of Vr and VL will be applied voltage V. So if I consider this as a V, this as a I, here the angle made by this V with this I, or this positive x axis direction, is I, and in anticlockwise sense it is ahead of I. So what is the conclusion? In series inductive circuit, which is nothing but a RL, the current lags the voltage applied by angle phi. Or in other words, what you can say, in inductive circuit voltage leads current by an angle phi. So if I consider this part of a circuit, I will get this triangle where all the sides are nothing but voltages. Hence I name this as voltage triangle. Now in a voltage triangle, I am having this line or this side as Vr, nothing but I into R, this side VL, I into XL, and this side is V, total applied voltage, nothing but I into Z. So from the voltage triangle, what I can say, I am simply applying a Pythagoras theorem. So V is nothing but root of Vr square plus VL square. So Vr we know it is I into R square plus VL I into XL square. So ultimately what I will get, V equal to I into root of R square plus XL square. Let's define the impedance now. So impedance is defined as the opposition of circuit to flow of alternating current, and it is denoted by Z. It is just like a resistance, hence unit is ohm. So If I take a voltage triangle, in a voltage triangle we have this side as I into R, this side I into XL, and the diagonal is I into Z. So in a voltage triangle, if I divide by I, because in series circuit I will remain same, I will get this as R, this as XL, this as Z. All the sides will have unit ohm, hence this is impedance triangle. So from impedance triangle, what we can say, this R is nothing but Z cos phi and XL is Z sin phi. Impedance in rectangle form, I can say it is Z equal to R plus JXL. So it concludes Z is a complex term. Impedance in phasor form, what I will have Z as mod Z at an angle phi. So mod Z is nothing but root of R square plus XL square. It's the magnitude of this complex term, and phi is the angle made by impedance with positive x-axis direction taken in anti-clockwise direction. So for inductive circuit, I can say phase angle of impedance is always positive. Power. So let's see the instantaneous power. So instantaneous power is given by P equal to V into I, where V equal to Vm sin omega t and I equal to Im sin omega t minus phi. So if I solve this, I will get Vm Im cos phi minus cos 2 omega t minus phi divided by 2. So if I multiply inside, I will get two terms. One term is Vm Im by 2 cos phi minus Vm Im by 2 cos 2 omega t minus phi. If you see carefully, both the terms looking like sinusoidal quantity. I agree to this point, but there is one difference. This is cos phi and this is cos 2 omega t minus phi. So if I plot all these terms with respect to omega t as a x-axis, I will get this quantity as a sinusoidal and this quantity as a constant term. So whenever I take an average of this term, obviously with over a complete cycle where omega t varies from 0 to 2 pi, I will get average of this term as 0, leaving behind only Vm Im by 2 into cos phi. So P average for inductive circuit is Vm Im by 2 into cos phi. If I divide these two in two terms, root 2, root 2, what I will get? Vm by root 2, Im by root 2 into cos phi. Vm by root 2 is Vrms, Im by root 2 is Irms. So what I will get average power as Vrms, Irms cos phi. Now let's see, along with the power P, we have two more powers denoted by Q and S. So I will get this power triangle resultant from impedance triangle or a voltage triangle. So along the x-axis direction, I have active, real or true power denoted by P. Along y-axis, in the imaginary axis, I will have Q, which is nothing but reactive power. And third side, which is a diagonal of this triangle, is apparent power denoted as S, with phi is the angle made by apparent power with P. Now let's define these terms. Apparent power denoted by S, it is defined as the product of RMS values of voltage and current. So S equal to V into I, its unit is volt ampere. At higher level, it will have a unit kilovolt ampere, also denoted as kVA. This is a power supplied by utility. Next, active or real or true power denoted by P. It is defined as the product of the applied voltage and the active component of the current. So active component of the current is I cos phi. So the product of voltage and active component is P equal to VI cos phi. Its unit is watt, or at higher level it's a kilowatt. This is the actual power consumed by a load. Next, reactive power denoted as Q. It is defined as the product of the applied voltage and the reactive component of P. the current. So reactive component of the current is I sin phi. So Q equal to VI sin phi. Its unit is volt ampere reactive. At higher level, it is having a unit kilovolt ampere kVAr. So along with the P, you will also have Q. Then it will become S as the total power supplied, but actually consumed power is P. Now, if I am supplying S, I am consuming P, who is going to decide from the supplied how much power I can be consumed? It is nothing but a power factor and denoted by cos phi. So it is defined as a factor by which the apparent power must be multiplied in order to obtain the true power. So power factor is a decisive factor who will decide how much power actually you are going to consume from the total power supplied. So power factor is given by true power divided by apparent power. So true power is VI cos phi, apparent power is VI. I will get power factor as cos phi. So from the impedance triangle, same cos phi is denoted by R by Z. Okay. Along with the power factor magnitude, one more thing we need to specify, and that is the nature of power factor is always determined by position of current with respect to the voltage. Meaning, for a series RL circuit or inductive circuit, what I am having? Current lags voltage by angle phi. So this phi, if I take a cosine of that, I will get a power factor. But cos phi for a positive angle as well as negative angle, it is positive. But how you are going to distinguish whether angle phi is positive or negative? That is decided by the nature of current with respect to voltage. So in case of an inductive circuit, current lags voltage by angle phi. Hence, power factor is cos phi and it is in lagging in nature, because current lags voltage by angle phi for inductive circuit. Thank you.